Welcome back to 9th class English medium students. Today we are going to learn about rationalizing the denominator. Okay, today's topic is rationalizing the denominator. For that, already you know the irrational numbers. What are the irrational numbers? The numbers which are not possible to write in the form of p by q. That means the irrational numbers are non-terminating, non-recurring decimals. So root 2, root 3, root 5, root 7, these are called irrational numbers. Already we know in the previous class how to locate root 2, root 3, root 5 on the number line. Today, we are going to, in the next slide, look there. Can we locate 1 by root 2 on the number line? Can we locate 1 by root 2 on the number line? We know that already how to locate root 2 on the number line. But now today's task is how to locate 1 by root 2 on the number line. 1 by root 2 on the number line. Imagine, is it possible or not? Or how can we locate 1 by root 2? Why? Because of already we know the root 2 is an irrational number. That means it is a non-terminating, non-recurring decimals. Then what is the value of 1 by root 2? Then what is the value of 1 by root 2? How do we find the 1 by root 2 on the number line? That means we may first try to find the value of 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2. What is the value of 1 by root 2? If we know it, then we can do it easily on the number line. What is the root 2 value? Already we find it in the long division method in the previous class. So 1.414 1.414 2 1 3 5 and so on. That means it is an non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. That means here you write that value of in the denominator 1 by 1.414 2 1 3 5. Is it possible to find the value of this division? It is not an easy task to us. Why? Because of the denominator is an irrational, non-terminating, non-recurring decimal. That means here you divide 1 by 1.414 2 1 3 5 and so on. It is not possible to us to find the value of 1 by root 2. Hence, we may go to the another way to find the 1 by root 2 value. After that, we may locate the 1 by root 2 on the number line easily. For that purpose, here you may observe 1 by root 2 is multiplied both the numerator and denominator by root 2 again. Here you may observe this point. this is the given number. What we did here, the numerator and the denominator is multiplied by root 2. Both the numerator and the denominator is multiplied by 2. Then what you get? 1 into root 2, root 2. And root 2 into root 2, already you know this. Root of 2 into 2. Where there are two equal factors in the root symbol, then the value is we take in one factor, that is 2. Now you know the value of root 2 already, what we written in the top of this slide, that is 1.414 2135 by 2. That means here root 2 by 2 means half of the root 2, that is half of the root 2. Already we know how to represent root 2 on number line. Then half of the root 2, where it is half of the root 2 means it lies between, the value of root 2 is 1.414 2135. Okay, now half of the root 2, half of the root 2, where it is, it lies between 0 to 1, that means 0 less than root 2 by 2 is less than 2. Why? Root 2. 0 less than root 2 by 2 less than root 2. That means the root 2 by 2 lies exactly half of the point between 0 and root 2. Root 2 by root 2 anedi 0 ki root 2 ki exact ga madhyalo untundi. So now it is easy to us to identify on the number line. When we locate root 2 on number line, after that we may go to the number line and draw the root 2. After that you may find the midpoint between 0 2 and root 2. You can identify easily. Then here you may observe the procedure what we followed here. What that is the important key point here, how can we locate the 1 by root 2 on number line. 1 by root 2 value is root 2 by 2, root 2 by 2. Okay, that means you may observe the denominators, what in the previous denominator and now present denominator. Look there, what are the previous denominators? Previous denominator is root 2. Now the denominator is 2. That means what happened? Look there, root 2 is converted into 2. That means root 2 is an irrational number, 2 is a rational number. That means the denominator may be converted into a rational number. Then that is easy to us. Now we locate the root 2 on number line. Okay. So that means this is the way rationalizing the denominator, it is need to us to solve the problems. Now here root 2 into root 2 gives us 2. That means an irrational number is converted into a rational number by on what way? We multiply it by the root 2 with the root 2, then we get 2. Then it converted as a rational number. We will take one more example. Root 2 into, you multiply it by root 8. Then what you get? Root 16. Root 16 means the square root of 16 is 4. Now it is also an irrational number. Now it is also a rational number. Not only this one, you may take one more example. Root 2 into root 18. Then what you get? Root 36. That means root of 6 into 6. Then what you get? 6. This is also a rational number. That means 2 is irrational, 4 is irrational, and the 6 is also a rational number. That means here this root 2 and root 2 are called rationalizing factors to each other. Here in the second one, root 2 and root 8 are also rationalizing factors to each other. In the third one, root 2 and root 18 is also rationalizing factors to each other. That means when we get a rational number, then those two are called factors to that rational numbers. అంటే ఇక్కడ మీరు గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాల్సిన అంశం ఏంటి అంటే రూట్ టూకి రూట్ టూ ఒక రేషనలైజింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్. ఒక రూట్ టూనే కాదు, రూట్ టూకి రూట్ ఎయిట్ ఇన్ ద సెకండ్, రూట్ టూకి రూట్ ఎయిట్తో మల్టిప్లై చేసినప్పుడు కూడా మనకి రేషనలైజేషన్ నెంబర్ వచ్చి రేషనల్ నెంబర్ వచ్చింది. అలానే రూట్ టూని రూట్ ఎయిట్తో మల్టిప్లై చేసినప్పుడు కూడా ఒక రేషనల్ నెంబర్ వచ్చింది. అంటే రూట్ టూని రేషనల్ ఫామ్లోకి కన్వర్షన్ చేయడానికి రూట్ టూ ఒకటే రేషనలైజేషన్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ కాదు. రూట్ టూ ఒక రేషనలైజ్ ఫ్యాక్టరే, రూట్ ఎయిట్ అయినా ఒక రేషనలైజ్ ఫ్యాక్టరే, ఒక రూట్ ఎయిటీన్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో అన్ రేషనలైజింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్. దట్ మీన్స్ హియర్ వాట్ వీ డిడ్ ఇన్ ద ప్రీవియస్ వన్, లుక్ హియర్ వాట్ వీ డిడ్, 1/√2 ఈజ్ మల్టిప్లైడ్ బై బోత్ √2/√2. అదర్వైజ్ యూ మే టేక్ హియర్ √8/√8 ఆన్ బిహాఫ్ ఆఫ్ √2/√2. యూ మే టేక్ √8/√8 ఆర్ √18/√8. వెదర్ యూ టేక్ ఎనీ these three, not only these three, you may go through, you may get so many means you may look like root 2 into root 32, what do you get? Root 64. That means the square root of 64 is 8. That means you may take root 32 by 32. So in this way we may convert the denominators which have irrational factors into rational numbers. So the rationalizing factor is not unique to anyone. We may get so many rationalizing factors. Okay, now we go to the next slide. We look there. Here, note, it is a note to you what I told you in the previous slide. Note that if the product of two irrational numbers is a rational number, then each of the two is a rationalizing factor of the other. That means root 2 into root 2 gives us 2, root 2 into root 8 gives 4. ఇక్కడ మీరు గుర్తుంచుకోవాల్సింది root 2 ని రెండుతో చేర్చబేసినప్పుడు రేషనల్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ రేషనల్ నెంబర్ వచ్చింది. రూట్ టూని రూట్ ఎయిట్తో మల్టిప్లై చేసినప్పుడు 4 అనే రేషనల్ నెంబర్ వచ్చింది. రూట్ టూని రూట్ ఎయిటీన్తో మల్టిప్లై చేసినప్పుడు 6 అనే రేషనల్ నెంబర్ వచ్చింది. కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ రూట్ టూ రేషనలైజింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్. రూట్ టూని రూట్ ఎయిట్తో మల్టిప్లై చేసినప్పుడు రూట్ టూ రూట్ ఎయిట్ కూడా రేషనలైజింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్. రూట్ టూని రూట్ ఎయిటీన్తో మల్టిప్లై చేసినప్పుడు ఆ రెండు కూడా రేషనలైజింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్. Look there. Also notice that the rationalizing factors of a given irrational number is not unique. It is convenient to use the simplest of all rationalizing factors. It is not unique ante kevalam root 2 ki root of 2 okate kaadu, root 2 ki root 8, root 2 ki root 18, root 2 ki root 32. అంటే మనకి రేషనల్ నెంబర్ రావటం కోసం దేనితోటి అయితే మల్టిప్లై చేస్తాము అవన్నీ కూడా రేషనలైజింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్సే. అయితే మన కన్వీనియంట్ కోసం సాల్వ్ చేయడానికి ఈజీగా సింప్లెస్ట్ ఫార్ములా ఉండే తీసుకొని చేస్తాము. ఆఫ్ గివెన్ రేషనల్ నెంబర్ యూ మే కీప్ ఇన్ మైండ్ దిస్ నోట్. ఓకే, నౌ వీ మూవ్ టు ద నెక్స్ట్ స్లైడ్. లుక్ దేర్ దేర్ ఈస్ ఎ డూ దిస్ ఫైండ్ rationalizing factors of the denominators of 1 by 2 root 3, 3 by root 5 and 1 by root 8. We may do this one. Solution for first one. 1 by 2 root 3. Now here you may observe what I am doing. 2 root 3 in the denominator. You multiplied both numerator and the denominator by root 3 and you observe what we get. In the numerator, 1 into root 3, root 3. In the denominator, 2 into, in the root symbol, here there is 2 root 3s, root 3 into root 3, you may write like this. Then what you get, root 3. By when there is two equal factors under the root symbol, you take one. Now you write root 3 by 6. Now you observe here in the denominator, in the starting 2 root 3, it is an irrational number. In the last step, what we get, 6 is a rational number. That means here when we get 6, we multiplied the both the numerator and denominator by root 3. Hence, here what is the rationalizing factor to the 2 root 3? Rationalizing factor. Rationalizing factor to 2 root 3 is what we find. Then the multiplication of 6 such in the 230. Hence you write root 3. Not only root 3. If you multiplied root 3 into root 27, then what you get? Root 3 into 27. That means root 81. That is equal to 9. 9 9 81. Here 9 is also a rational number, as in the 6, as in 6, as like 6. 6 is a rational number, 9 is also a rational number. And that root 3 to multiply this. Now, root 27 to multiply this. And unique can you put that? And 2 root 3 rationalizing factor root 3 is equal to root 27 కూడా అవుతుంది. ఇలా దేర్ ఆర్ సో మెనీ వీ గెట్. యూ మే డూ ఎనీ వన్, యూ టేక్ ఎనీ వన్. హియర్ ఇన్ ద సెకండ్ వన్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద సెకండ్ క్వశ్చన్ హియర్? 3 by root 5. నౌ యూ అబ్జర్వ్ హియర్ హౌ కెన్ సాల్వ్ దిస్ వన్. 3 by root 5, యూ రైట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డినామినేటర్ హియర్? రూట్ 5. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఈజీ టు అస్ to multiply the given number, given real number into the both the numerator and denominator by root 5. Now you write like this. Here what we did, 3 into root 5, 3 root 5 in the numerator part. In the denominator part, root 5 into root 5, that means root of 5 into 5. If there are two equal factors in the square root symbol, then you take 1. That means 3 root 5 by root 5. Okay. So, here you may observe root 5 by 5. Here what do you say about 5? 5 is a rational number. What is the beginning in the denominator? Root 5. Here root 5 is an irrational. Finally, what we get? 5 is irrational. That means here root 5 rationalizing factor to root 5 is root 5, not only root 5. You may get so many like in the previous one. ఇంత ముందు చెప్పిన దాంట్లో ఎలాగైతే రూట్ త్రీతో మల్టిప్లై చేసా, రూట్ 27తో మల్టిప్లై చేసా, రేషనల్ నెంబర్ వచ్చింది. అలానే ఇక్కడ నేను ఒక చేశాను రూట్ 5ని 5 లాగా మార్చడానికి, మనం రూట్ 5 తోటి న్యూమరేటర్ని డినామినేటర్ని మల్టిప్లై చేసాము. ఇక్కడ రూట్ 5 తోటి కాకుండా ఇంకా దేనితోటి మల్టిప్లై చేస్తే డినామినేటర్ రేషనల్ నెంబర్ వస్తుందో ట్రై చేసి చూడండి. ఇంకా కొన్ని వస్తాయి, ఇంకా మనకి చాలా వస్తాయన్నమాట రేషనలైజింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్, నాట్ ఓన్లీ రూట్ 5. యూ మే డూ ద థర్డ్ వన్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద థర్డ్ వన్? యూ మే డూ దిస్ ఎట్ యువర్ నోట్బుక్స్ ఇన్ అవర్ హోమ్. జస్ట్ ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ యూ 1/√8. నౌ వాట్ డూ యూ యూ మే మల్టిప్లై విత్ బై root 8 by root 8 or root 2 by root 2. You think like that, finally you may get rational number. For that purpose you may multiply both numerator and denominator by root 2 or root 8. You may get a rationalizing factor easily. You may do this, the last one, at your home. Okay, thank you.